Hello, I'm Jean Steiner, Director of the U.S. Department of Agriculture's Grazinglands Research Laboratory in El Reno, Oklahoma. In this role, I also lead the USDA Southern Plains Climate Hub and serve as an affiliate professor at the University of Oklahoma. In this video, I'll be discussing how climate affects agriculture and the climate footprint of agricultural systems. In studies of the interaction of climate and human systems, agriculture plays a central role. All humans rely on agriculture to produce food that is essential for life and a multitude of fiber, fuel, and other products that are central to our well-being. Grazing lands are a large percentage of the global and national land use and thereby are greatly exposed to climate and cause significant earth-atmosphere feedback loops. In the U.S., privately owned pasture land occupies 120 million acres, or 6% of the total U.S. land area. Rangelands occupy 400 million acres, or 21% of the total land in the U.S. Additionally, a significant portion of the 400 million acres of federally owned land includes additional grazed rangeland and forest land. Agriculture is a large economic sector nationally and regionally. Focusing on the southern plain states of Kansas, Oklahoma, and Texas, the total farm gate income in the region was $60 billion in 2012. Livestock sectors that produce more than $1 billion of income in the region include beef cattle, poultry and eggs, dairy, and swine production, for a total of over $35 billion produced by these livestock enterprises. Livestock systems are highly vulnerable to many types of climate risks. The nature of the risk and adaptation and mitigation strategies are different for extensive livestock grazing systems, such as beef cattle and other ruminant livestock systems, as compared to intensive livestock production that is operated in confined housing, such as those that dominate the U.S. production of swine, poultry and egg, and much of the U.S. dairy. For extensive livestock systems, key climate risks include direct risk associated with animal health and productivity, as well as indirect risks associated with adequacy of forage quality and supply and water supply. My discussion of the key risks will focus on those most important where I work, in the southern plains of the U.S. Grazing animals require year-round forages. Changes in rainfall and temperature patterns lead to long-term risk to available forage, both in pastures and rangeland, as well as in grazed annual crops such as winter wheat. Increased evaporation rates related to high temperatures, low humidity, and high wind speeds exacerbate plant stress and accelerate decline of surface reservoir and groundwater levels. These declines lead to long-term risk to feed and forage, and they create increased stress on water supplies for beef cattle consumption. Longer droughts and more intense storms pose direct and indirect threats to livestock production systems. For native pastures, vegetation shifts may influence sensitive species that are an important part of the ecological benefit of native rangelands. Additionally, expansion of woody plants such as eastern red cedar or mesquite into native grasslands reduces productivity and carrying capacity, as well as increases risk of wildfire. Exposure to extreme temperatures, both heat waves and cold snaps, pose significant threats to the health, well-being, and productivity of livestock. Rapid and extreme changes in temperature can result in increased stress, loss of productivity, and death losses. For intensive livestock systems, demands for water and energy and its associated higher cost spike during heat waves. Livestock experience higher pest pressure due to changing climate patterns. As the range for insects and diseases move northward, livestock are exposed to different pests than in the past, requiring managers to adapt with new monitoring and treatment programs. Extreme weather events such as blizzards, drought, hurricanes, and severe storms pose threats to exposed livestock and to animal facilities. Confined animal facilities are very expensive, and so risk associated with damage from severe weather is large. But even in extensive grazing systems, damage from extreme storms may result in expensive repair for fencing and structures. In the face of these risks, producers can use several adaptation strategies to enhance resilience of livestock systems. For example, Producers can adopt or develop breeds that are more tolerant to extremes of heat and cold and with enhanced insect and disease resistance. Also, we can develop forage varieties that are better suited to extreme climate and pests. Adaptive grazing management provides flexibility to match forage availability and demand by changing stocking rates, time, and season of grazing. Other proactive management strategies can reduce invasive species to reduce risk of wildfires and promote resiliency of native plant communities. Producers can develop water supplies for herds that are less vulnerable to drying up during drought. Even constructing facilities or planting trees and shrubs will shade and cool cattle, helping them to adapt to climate extremes. Or land used for producing feed and forage can be converted from conventional tillage to no-till with the inclusion of cover crops, adding other sources of grazing and hay. Finally, marketing and insurance programs can be used for additional risk management. Not only can livestock producers adapt to our changing climate, but they can actively mitigate greenhouse gas emissions. For example, by improving forage quality, we can improve cattle production and reduce methane emissions. Or we can develop breeds that use nutrients from forages and feeds more efficiently. Carbon can be sequestered in the soil by adding cover crops and using no-till land management. These management strategies also reduce fuel consumption. Finally, we can improve the energy and water efficiency of animal housing facilities for both mitigation and adaptation, including the adoption of improved waste handling systems. As you can see, agriculture producers have many management decisions to make in the face of our changing climate.